Hi everyone, and welcome back to another Doctor Petrol video. Today, I want to discuss a massive project, a project of a global scale, and a project that you probably don't even know is happening in the background, even though you're contributing to it yourself every day. Every day, you're helping shape the future of personal transport. But you probably don't know about this, so let me explain. It all comes down to the little known ingenuity behind what you probably consider to be a daily annoyance on the web. Captchas, or specifically Google's ReCaptcha. Now you're probably wondering what captchas have to do with cars, but bear with me, because Google has been using ReCaptcha to shape the future of the personal car since 2012. It all started with the invention of the captcha in the early 2000s. The name captcha is short for completely automated public Turing test to tell computers and humans apart. Initially, its sole purpose was to filter out the vast amounts of spam bots pretending to be people on websites. It displayed some form of distorted text that a computer couldn't possibly read, but a human could. All a user had to do was type the text in the box to gain access to whatever the captcha was protecting. The tool proved massively successful, and captchas were soon to be found all over the internet, with millions of people filling them out on a daily basis. But one of the inventors of the captcha, Louis von Ahn, wasn't satisfied. Millions of people were translating nonsensical images into text, which was a waste of human time that could be used adding value for free. This led to the invention of ReCaptcha. Users were still typing in letters and numbers, but rather than random words, ReCaptcha required users to translate images of real words and numbers taken from archival text. This new application was first used to digitize the archives of the New York Times by letting people transcribe words that digitization machines couldn't read. After the system digitized the complete New York Times archives, dating back to as far as 1851, the technology was sold to Google, who used it to transcribe old books for Google Books, a digital database of books. That's right, you have likely worked for free for Google without even knowing it. By 2011, the complete Google Books archive had been digitized, which happily coincided with the rise of artificial intelligence and machine learning. And this is where Google driverless car came in, better known as Waymo nowadays. The name Waymo is derived from its mission, a new way forward in mobility. Quite literally. But how do human inputs into captchas help driverless cars become smarter? This all comes down to the simple fact that machine learning, despite its name, requires an enormous amount of human-labeled visual data to train the optical character recognition of the artificial intelligence. Basically, this means that for any computer to learn by itself and become smarter, it needs a human to tell what it is seeing in the first place. And this is where the captchas come into play. You probably remember being asked to identify traffic lights, cars, trucks, shop fronts and the likes on images broken up into 9 squares. This is basically you telling a computer what is what so that it builds an understanding of what a traffic light or a car looks like. This was particularly necessary in the early days of Google's driverless cars when machine learning was at its infancy. Nowadays, most visual classification is done with very clever algorithms that learn incredibly rapidly and so accurately that they make human confirmations effectively unnecessary. Furthermore, Waymo engineers have created a program called CarCraft, which is a virtual world where driving conditions are simulated, inspired by the game World of Warcraft. Waymo has 25,000 virtual self-driving cars on the road in virtual copies of cities like Austin, Mountain View, and Phoenix, where their cars have driven over 5 billion miles as of 2018. So, why are you still being asked to identify different elements of traffic in ReCaptcha then? Despite Waymo nor Google being all too open about this, it's most likely to double check their classifiers. When it comes to driverless cars and all the scrutiny companies that offer them have to go through, they can't be careful enough to make sure that that data is correct. Therefore, the data from ReCaptcha is probably being used nowadays to make sure that when the algorithm identifies an object or makes a decision, a human agrees with it. So, in actual fact, you are double checking the accuracy of a driverless car's brain by logging into your favorite website, buying tickets online, or just shopping online. Quite extraordinary, isn't it? And all that without even knowing or realizing it. Well, now you do, and I hope you enjoyed this insight. If you did, give the video a thumbs up, subscribe for more videos to come in the future, and I'll catch you at the next Dr. Petrol video.